Hey everyone, this is Stephanie Wong, and today I'm here with Warren Barkley, our Senior Director of Product Management for Vertex AI. We're going to share three recent generative AI announcements and talk about what they mean for our customers. So let's dive in. First, we recently announced Gemini 1.5, our fastest and most cost-efficient model yet. With Flash, you get our 1 million token context window, 40% faster performance than GPT 3.5 Turbo, and up to 4 times lower input price. Next up, we have Gemini 1.5 Pro, which is now available with a context window of up to 2 million tokens. We'll talk about how this enables you to unlock unique multimodal use cases that no other model can handle. And third, context caching for both Gemini 1.5 Pro and Flash, which helps customers reduce input costs by 75%, leveraging cached data of frequently used context. So I just want to dive straight into this context window. We know that 1.5 Pro is GA, and it has a huge 2 million token context window. So what are you looking forward to trying out, or what kind of use cases require longer context windows, and how does this help?
Yeah, there's just some really pretty amazing things you can do with it. Like say if you want to take something like the entire Dune series of books, and then you want to ask questions about the plot through the whole series or things that are common about it, you can take all those books and put it into the same context window just in one time, turn the model once. Or even more kind of on the business side, if you want to take the audio transcripts of like a company for the last couple of years, even you can feed hours and tens of hours of that in and ask pretty complicated questions about what was the tone, what changed, what are things that keep on getting repeated, what are themes. And so things like that, if you're using video, using audio, they actually need that bigger context window for you to do interesting things with. So that's some of the things we've been seeing people experiment with, and it's really cool to see the results.
I'm not going to lie, I tried to read Dune. It is a dense book, so having a context window to analyze it would be really useful for me.
Yeah, it'll take a long time to read all of them too, right? So it would be, it's kind of the Cliff Notes version if you need to get the plot. So yeah.
Exactly. Well, we also have Gemini Flash. And so what are the differences between 1.5 Pro and Flash? Where are the use cases that are more appropriate for Flash?
Yeah, for Flash, if you don't need, you know, kind of complicated reasoning, maybe you want to ask more simplistic questions where you're not doing kind of a chain of thought type of reasoning thing, then Flash tends to be more appropriate. Flash is cheaper, Flash is faster. And so there's things where you have, you know, you need an answer in a second, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, something like that. You want to do something faster. Different types of conversational things people would use Flash for. And so really it's just a question of mostly around speed and latency, but a little bit around more complicated reasoning tasks where Pro does slightly better.
Amazing. It's nice to have differentiation and just choice there. And now one of the biggest launches here is also context caching, which I think is going to be huge for many customers. How does that work specifically?
Yes, really a very cool context caching. Basically, so take all those Dune books and put them in, and then you can ask a series of questions against it without actually having to reload that context over and over and over again. And it's really about cost. And so, you know, when you load a bunch of data into the model, you don't want to have to pay every time you load that same data in. And so context caching, you turn that on, it's just a flag in the API, you can turn that on, and then you can ask multiple questions, and it saves you a ton of money, obviously.
Yeah, with a context window of 2 million, I think that's very useful.
Yeah.
Now, for our open source developers out there, I want to also discuss Gemma 2, which is going GA. What does this mean for developers?
Yeah, so Gemma is an open source model, and it's quite a bit smaller than some of our other models. And so if you want to do this and experiment with it or do research with it, and you don't want have the resources, the computational resources to do some of these bigger things on some of these bigger models, then Gemma is really a great option. You can maybe use that locally on even desktop type machines. You may want to really dive deep into the model and do some types of tuning and things like that that you couldn't do on some of the bigger models. And so really it's an awesome tool if you want a ton of flexibility and maybe something that will run a little bit faster with a less heavyweight than some of the bigger models we have.
And these are available on Vertex AI today?
Correct. Yeah, all those models that you just talked about are available on Vertex AI. And in fact, a model garden has hundreds of models in it that are available now that you can use and experiment with from models that come from us, from open source models, models that come from other folks like Mistral and Meta and people like that as well.
Amazing. Well, there is so much going on this year, and I want to thank you for joining us today, Warren.
Thank you.
And we'll see everyone next time.